in the speaker's chair. The new Republican majority says cutting spending is by far its top mission. And already there are signs some Republicans want to cut even more than their leadership. Among them is Congressman Mike Pence of Indiana, who gave up a leadership post because he wanted the freedom to speak more freely and the freedom, perhaps, to consider a run for president. Congressman, it's good to see you on this night.
Thank you, John.
You do not believe there's any room for new spending at this moment, correct?
Well, it's not just what I believe, John. I think the American people sent a deafening message on Election Day last November that they want a fundamental change of direction. They want us to end this era of borrowing and spending and bailouts and takeovers and turn this national government back in the direction of fiscal solvency and reform.
So what does the president have to do that? He will call this a Sputnik moment. He will say, just like John Kennedy responded to the Soviets who were in space before us, that if we don't invest in research and development, in new roads and bridges, in new science projects, right, that we will fall behind China, behind India. Right. Is that completely out of the realm, or will you say, I will listen to you, Mr. President, if you show me first a lot of cuts?
Well, let me say, we welcome the President of the United States to the House chamber today. He'll be given the respect that both he and his office are due. But, I'm thinking back of the 1990s in the Clinton era when I think the word investment became a synonym for more federal spending. Not only are kind of House Republicans onto that, John, I think the American people are onto that. They know that we're running now multiple years in a row of more than $1 trillion deficits. The kind of investment we should be encouraging is investment in America by Americans and by American businesses. And frankly, many of us are hoping tonight that the president will open the door to additional tax relief that will release some of those corporate profits, additional tax relief that will encourage investment by Americans in the city and on the farm in ways that will create jobs. Washington investment is not going to get this economy moving again. Getting the American people to invest and believe in their future again will.
Tonight is in many ways the first act in a great new drama of divided government. And not only do you have how will the president and the new Republican House get along, but you have in your own caucus in the House debates about the levels of cuts that should be necessary. And you have seen this play out in recent days where I believe you are on the side of those saying the leadership so far is being too timid, needs to cut even more. You obviously only control the House of Representatives. So how far do you think the House needs to go, essentially for leverage, when you get into the negotiations with a narrowly Democratic Senate and a Democratic president who won't get as much as you want? And you know that.
Well, look, I don't know that. I really believe that a minority in the Senate plus the American people equals a majority. And House Republicans are determined to do two things. Number one, we're going to keep our promise to the American people. Our resolution today, we embraced $100 billion in cuts this year. But as we move legislation forward in the coming weeks, you're going to see House Republicans say, we can do more. We can find greater savings in every area of government. We're going to lay out, both in a resolution, in the debt ceiling vote, ultimately in our budget, as Paul Ryan will discuss tonight, a vision for really putting our nation back on a pathway toward fiscal solvency and that lodestar of a balanced federal budget. The American people know we have to do better. House Republicans are going to drive toward that, and I believe with the American people on our side, anything's possible.
You mentioned the official response from Paul Ryan. Michelle Bachmann will also give a response. It was originally set up as just to go to the website of the Tea Party Express. Now, she has invited in cameras, and some see this as a little bit of a tug of war, a little bit of a turf battle, where the Tea Party Express still a bit suspicious of the Republican leadership, of the Republican establishment. Do you share that suspicion, and do you worry at all that it sends a mixed message to the American people about sort of who speaks for the Republican Party?
I'm not worried at all about a mixed message. Paul Ryan's going to do a terrific job tonight. He is a principled conservative and is going to present a winning and positive and substantive message. And Michelle Bachmann, I know, will do the same thing. And look, the more voices we have in the public debate that are calling for fiscal responsibility and reform and putting our nation back on a pathway to growth, the better.
You could be in a leadership position in this Congress. You decided not to run for re-election at that position to give yourself a little time to think, a little freedom to speak on issues like this, but also to decide whether you want to run for president or maybe for governor of Indiana. As you know, a number of conservatives have looked at some of the others thinking about running, and they're not happy. And they've started a draft Mike Pence movement. Can you tell us tonight, are you going to run for president?
Nice try, John. Look, we're nearing the end of a process that began a couple of months ago, and my little family and I are just trying to discern where we have the best opportunity to serve and to advance the conservative values that carried us into public life 10 years ago. But no decision tonight, but we'll keep you posted.
You won't tell me whether you want to deliver a State of the State address some night in Indianapolis or whether you'd like to give a State of the Union address over there some night? Or both?
I'll tell you someday.
What's the biggest decision maker for you?
Well, the biggest decision maker for us is really where we can make the most difference for the values that carried us to public life. Look, I was called into public
guy,
service.
Hard for a House guy to win the presidency.
Well, I was called into public service to really stand for a set of principles. I've been very humbled by the encouragement we've received from people around Indiana and around the country who see some consistency in the way we've advocated the principles of limited government, fiscal responsibility, traditional values, and a strong defense. And what our little family is trying to discern with some help from some good counsel is where do we have the opportunity to really make a difference for those values in the years ahead.
Congressman Pence, hope you'll stay in touch as you make that decision. We're going to head to break now. Congressman Pence may be running for president in the next cycle. When we come back, the man who was the president's opponent in the last election cycle.